everybody to episode 17 of my 2022 my camera. Let's everybody see what happens.
If only security had done their jobs that night, Samoa Joe never would have made it past the arena's metal detector. Sorry, trying to keep it positive.
Which is hard to do because our story wouldn't be complete without talking about one giant negative. I'm referring, of course, to the arrival of the American hero, Brooklyn Von Braun, in WWE.
Because of Brooklyn, our lives and careers would never be the same. Although, if you think about it, they were pretty much the same as they'd always been, because no matter where we went or what we accomplished, we could never escape Brooklyn's loud, obnoxious shadow.
We gave Brooklyn a lot of chances to prove she had changed. Well, mostly traded. But ultimately, she only proved one thing. She was the exact same bully she was way back when we were in high school.
And she wasn't just a jerk to us. She disrespected anyone she dealt with, including WWE legends.
What if you got angle? Didn't you understand? Can't believe that man's back. With everything we did to him and get the US title view Universal Championship off him, I thought I'd be in the last in the South Jail. But apparently he comes and interrupted himself.
Is that all you've got? It feels like you're taking a teacup poodle for a walk on my back.
Excuse me, Ms. Von Braun, can we talk?
Can't you see I'm conducting important GM business? Come on, I really need you to get in there. Work it!
It will only take a minute.
What? I don't want my car washed or candy from your stupid kid's fundraiser or whatever crap you're selling.
Actually, I'm the original American hero, Kurt. You know, the Hall of Famer you borrowed your nickname from without asking.
Come back in five with stronger hands. Well, so what do you want? An autograph from the real American hero? A picture? Tell me what I need to do to make you go away.
I need you to drop the lawsuit against me. If you don't, it will bankrupt my family.
No chance. I'm the way more famous American hero, and I will not allow you to profiting off my celebrity.
I won a gold medal for my country with a broken freaking neck. What have you ever done that makes you an American hero?
Filed a trademark? Security!
Wait, maybe we can settle this without lawyers. If there's anything that could change your mind, I'd do it.
Anything? It just so happens we have a superstar who was gone for a very long time and needs to knock off some ring rust. So I'll drop the lawsuit if you can beat Samoa Joe.
But Joe's a monster. He's got that bionic arm that could tear me apart. And I haven't competed in years.
Samoa Joe hasn't competed in years either. So it should be a competitive match.
Good
luck.
Welcome to Angle.
Oh. This is a match I never expected to see tonight. Kurt Angle has been retired for years. Brooklyn Brock Braun's legal case against Angle has clearly caused him distress so much that he's willing to risk his well-being to get Brooklyn to drop the lawsuit altogether.
But Kurt Angle should have just stopped using the American Hero nickname when he had the chance, and none of this would be happening. Instead, he let his pride get in the way of rational thinking. Now he's in for a world of physical and financial suffering. And very body control. He also fought that attack. But no fight left. I think he's a bit overstepping that. The cover. Apparently a change in plans here. You won't see as wide a breadth of experience as you would watching Samoa Joe. You have traveled the world and encountered this industry as much as Joe had without playing a few tricks of the trade. It is why Joe possesses the ability to stay calm with big fights.
That's how you wear down your opponent.
Company to fight as Mark Angle.
Since you like getting involved in my business so much, maybe you should pay all the legal bills for the lawsuit I have to drop now.
Yeah? Well, you messed with us in the Best of Five series, and that cost Red her title. So I'd say we're even now.
Is that what you think happened? I signed Samoa Joe because he was unfairly let go from WWE, not to mention he's a great addition to the roster. But I had nothing to do with him costing you the series. I don't control him. No one can. Which is something you should be very worried about.
Mm-hmm. So you're not out to get us? Then prove it. Give me a rematch for my championship that I lost without ever being pinned.
Let me think about that.
No. That's what I thought. But what I will do is give the audience something new and fresh.
Trey, you're going to face Adam Cole next week for his WWE Championship in a no-disqualification match. See? Maybe I'm not so bad after all. Now if you'll excuse me, I need to go find someone else I can sue to recoup my losses.
Cool.
Thank you.
It's a big time opportunity, Byron. It's the title. We're on the line here. You're right, Michael. And judging from the response on social media heading into this match, we're likely to see a new champ crown.
I've got no explanation of why Joe did that. And we need answers.
Champion, and I was about to team with none other than Ronda Rousey in the Mixed Match Challenge. The truth is, I couldn't enjoy any of that. I had a maniac breathing down my neck who spent 7 years planning my demise. But at least my title defense against Adam Cole would take place in a steel cage, so that psychopath couldn't interfere.
Mm-hmm.
Or so I thought.
Challenge. That is such a good picture, Trey. Yeah, so how did you make a good partnership together? Well, my team is a partner. You should get up at what Brooklyn's got planned for me. I hope it's not that we can both agree on. I think that Brooklyn's a good person. I don't want to not interfere. Oh, we did this.
Yeah.
I am cold.
Thank you.
WWE champion. Welcome today.
More importantly, I showed everyone I didn't need Samoa Joe's help.
Do you have anything left in the tank for your mixed match challenge later?
Honestly, I'm running on fumes, so I'm kind of hoping Ronda carries our team tonight. By the way, do you even have a partner yet?
No. Brooklyn's making me wait until the last minute to find out who it is. Typical.
Well, whoever it is, we might have to face each other at some point, which is going to be weird.
I know, but FYI, win mixed match challenge on the list, and I plan on being the one who crosses it off.
We'll see.
Let's pick someone real quick.
Hope you're feeling alright after that steel cage match.
Look, if you're worried about our match later, I'll be fine. Turns out I actually performed better with possibly cracked ribs.
Just remember, the winning mixed match challenge team gets $500,000 to donate to whatever charity they want. I don't want to miss out on that because you've got your hands full of other things.
Yeah. My hands aren't full at all. Look, completely empty. I even had time to think of an awesome team name. Team Rowdy Trey.
You clearly just thought of that, so I think that proves my point about you being distracted.
No, that took weeks of brainstorming. I swear, I even had a think tank put their heads together on it.
Whatever, just make sure you bring your A game later.
Finally! Look!
The mixed match challenge starts tonight, and everyone else knows who they're teaming with. So when are you going to tell me who my partner is on my way to the ring? Oh, did I forget to assign you a partner?
Must have slipped my mind.
Yeah, I'm sure. To make it up to you, I'll let you choose your teammate.
Great. I choose Seth Rollins. You didn't let me finish. I'll let you choose from my group of superstars that I've selected. Is Seth Rollins one of them? No. Your choices are Curt Hawkins, who's now lost over 1,000 consecutive matches, your old trainer, Riley Flash, who I have no doubt is in tremendous ring shape, especially after just flying in from Calgary on 6 connections. It was the cheapest fare I could get last minute. And finally, Drew McIntyre. You might remember he recently helped Becky Lynch acquire your SmackDown Live Women's Championship, so I'm sure you two would work really well together. I know it must be hard to pick from those three amazing options, but I need an answer now. See, when you're willing to put your gas station toilet seat of an attitude aside, we can work together after all.
Okay. Hey, she just met you. Sorry, time. you and Tanner say a beautiful woman's world championship.
As the next match challenge kicks off, most teams had a week to prepare. The Brooklyn Montour Dragon Big Legs team formed this moments ago. This has to be a major disadvantage. I agree, not to mention, they didn't even have time to come up with a cool team. That should be the least of their concerns, Zach. And Bishop Bishop Ryan Flats is on a match like 30 years.
Oh, she's mad for me, Monito. Coming in and making an impact for her, his partner, Ned.
That's how you wear down your opponent. The switch here to
let's read it off! Woo! And then Ben and Ryan flash on the first match of the mixed match challenge. Bye! invitation. No.
This man is a
superstar. It's 14-3. Perfectly. Oh, no, danger. Oh! What a move on the 15. I'm just covering the perimeter. Dude, it's like he didn't support him in NXT and they both face each other. I mean, now I just. Dude, remember DDT at a 15. I think Danger managed to escape that pinfall. Oh, neckbreaker! I'm nearly at fifth place. I think 15 needs some help by Bianca Belair. Cautiously back to the locker room.
Throughout last week, the doctor just said that Rhonda has to pull out of the mixed match challenge.
Damn it.
But I got some good news. I already found you a new partner.
Great.
Let me guess. You found someone who hasn't competed in WWE in 30 years.
Actually, I found someone who's never competed in WWE at all. Me! I'm stepping down as GM to become an active WWE superstar.
Cool.
I've been thinking about making the move to in-ring competitor for a while now, and this seemed like the perfect opportunity, especially with a chance to win money for charity. I just love giving back to the community whenever I can. Anyway, let me know if you want to talk strategy before our match tonight. Oh, and one more thing. I tied up some loose ends before I stepped down as GM. You're going to defend your WWE Championship against Samoa Joe on the special 1500th episode of SmackDown Live in a submission match. Later, partner.
Oh, God. They're just in the power of his own now. What is he really going to do now? I'm not really going to do anything now.